Good afternoon, students. So already we have completed two chapters. So now let us enter into another third chapter, that is nothing but magnetic effects of electric current. Okay. So in this chapter, first we are going to study about what is meant by magnetic field. We have learned about electric field, right? Similarly, magnetic field also nothing but, let me take a real magnet. This is the real magnet. It has two terminals. This is the north and south. Okay. Around the magnet there is a region where the force of attraction or the force of repulsion can be felt. And that region only we can call it as a kind of magnetic field. The magnetic field is represented by the magnetic lines of similar the electric field. Okay, it starts from the north to south outside the magnet and inside or not, south to north. Electric fields inside the conductor will be zero, but the magnetic field will not be zero. It travels from south, north to south outside and south to north or not inside. Okay, and the magnetic field first observed by the scientist Oersted. Okay, the magnetic field first observed by the scientist Oersted. He did an experiment and he taken a battery, and here if you want you can connect the rheostat, and the other terminal of the wire is passes through the midpoint of a cardboard. And here we spread some iron fillings over there, and if the cardboard is slightly disturbed, we can able to find out or not the iron fillings are arranged in the form of concentric circle. That means the current will be moving towards this direction, correct? Na? The current moving through the conductor just alter the space around the conductor. That means it will create a magnetic field. That is found by the scientist Oersted. But actually, it was found by his student Tesla. Okay, Tesla is a mischief guy in the class. Once Oersted took them to the physics laboratory, that time he took a magnetic compass and kept inside his pocket. The next day, again Oersted took them to the physics lab. And he did some experiment related to the current electricity. That time the Tesla was playing with that magnetic needle. And he placed the magnetic needle very close to the current carrying conductor. The current carrying conductor shows some deflection. He was amazed and shouted. And he told to his teacher, that means Oersted. Then Oersted developed, and he found that a current carrying conductor will alter the space around the magnet, and that area he called as what, not a magnetic field. That area only we can call it as magnetic field. Okay, the magnetic field denoted by a unit Tesla to give some fame. His name we are using what, not a Tesla as a unit of magnetic field. If you want to represent it, is denoted by the letter capital T. So that is a unit for magnetic field. So instead of using iron fillings, if you are using a magnetic needle, so it has a north and south pole. What will happen? The magnetic needle just deflected. If you want to find out the direction of the deflection of the magnetic needle, we can use swimming rule. Okay, da? Swimming rule means nothing but, let us assume that here there is a person. Okay. Let us assume that he is swimming, and the current entering from his leg to head. Let us assume this is the leg to head. Okay. So this is the direction of the current. Then the assume that the current was not entering from left to, that means leg to head. That means let us assume that the current entering from, let us take, this is east, west, south and north. So the current entering from north to south. Okay. So if the current entering from north to south over a magnetic field, then the north pole of the magnetic field deflected towards the south west direction. See, simply we can call it as this as nose rule. Don't forget nose. If the what is the real meaning of that? You see, if the current enters from north to south over a magnetic field, then the magnetic north pole of the magnetic field deflected towards the east direction. Okay. Or we can call this what not a snow rule. Snow rule. The snow rule means if the current enters from south to north over a magnetic needle, then the north pole will be deflected towards what not a west direction. Here towards the east direction, and here you can find your deflected towards the west direction. This we can call the snow rule. Okay. Or simply we can call it as what not a Ampere swimming rule. The Ampere swimming rule says that if the current enters from the leg to head, or the direction of the current is given by the leg to head, then the left hand, the deflection of the left hand gives the direction of the magnetic needle. In which direction it gets deflected, that we can able to find out by using one of the Ampere circuital law. Okay. So now, our Ampere swimming rule, the second rule we can call the snow rule. There are so many rules, okay. So in the 10th standard, you might have learned about what are the three important things. The first one is a straight conductor. If a straight conductor, how the magnetic field will be produced? For example, let us assume that it's a straight conductor. The current entering from the conductor, from which side? From south to north, okay. So it will create a magnetic field, and the magnetic field will be denoted by the concentric circles. If you want to find out the magnetic field direction here, just use right hand thumb rule. The right hand thumb rule says that if you are holding a current carrying conductor in your right hand, if the thumb indicates the direction of the current, then the curl finger indicates, these are the curl fingers, okay? The curl finger indicates the direction of the magnetic field. So let me use here. So this is the current carrying conductor. Here the fingers are coming out. Okay. So the magnetic field will be coming out this direction and going here. That can be denoted by the letter dot. And here into. Dot means the meaning that the magnetic field is coming out perpendicular to the plane. Don't forget, it is coming out. Dot means it is coming out. Into. Into means what? Going into. So here it is going into the plane, but perpendicular to the plane. Okay. Here it is coming out. Here what not a going into. Okay. So we can able to see hereafter the magnetic field will be denoted by only this. The dot means it's coming out. The into is there means the magnetic field is what not a acting or going into the field. That can be denoted by what not the given thing. Okay. So the dot indicates that it's coming out. The into indicates that it's going into the plane. Okay. So here the magnetic field depends on current. If you increase the current, the magnetic field also will be increased. The magnetic field is denoted by the letter B. So if you are increasing the current, the magnetic field also increases. If you are increasing the distance, the magnetic field will go to decrease. That means very close to the conductor, the fields are dense together. When you are coming far away from the conductor, the distance between the two field lines will be decreases, because magnetic field inversely proportional to what not a distance. So these are the two factors which can affect the magnetic field produced by what not a straight conductor. Okay. Now let us move on to a circular coil. For a circular coil, now see, let me bend the same conductor into the coil. Okay, I am going to bend the conductor induced by it. So here the current is moving this direction. So here the current is coming and it's coming up. So let us use the Fleming's right hand rule here. So according to that, here I am going to the outside of the conductor, it is coming out. So this is the, so it is coming out. It will go here. The middle, you can find a straight line, then this will be the magnetic lines. Okay, so here the magnetic lines are coming out. So here the magnetic lines will be going into. So here also going into, and here it will be coming out. That means here it's a dot. Inside you can find into, again outside it will be the dot. Here you have to use the right hand thumb rule, but in which direction? Opposite. So you take this way. So the field will be coming out here and going into the, okay. At the center, you see that at the center you can find the magnetic fields are almost parallel lines at the midpoints. So these parallel lines indicates that the field is uniform. At the midpoint, the field will be uniform. All other cases, the field will be non-uniform. Okay. So this is for a circular coil. For a circular coil, there are three factors. One is field depends on the current, directly proportional. And the field inversely proportional to the distance, and the field directly proportional to the number of turns. If you are increasing the turns, again the strength of the magnetic field also increases. Again, if you are moving away from the conductor, that means the d is the distance. Okay, if you are moving away from the conductor, the strength of the magnetic field decreases. Okay, then you will experience a force when a current carrying conductor, see, placed in a magnetic field. When a current carrying conductor placed in a magnetic field, it will experience a force. Already we have learned about what not a electric force. Electric force means, let us say this is a plate, as in the, these are the positive charges, these are the negative. Let me take a capacitor plates. Okay, so here you can find there is an electric field. If I am going to send a electron towards here, what will happen? The electron will enter perpendicular to the electric field. When it is enter perpendicular to the electric field, these negative charges will repel the electron. At the same time, the positive charge will attract the electron. So instead of going straight line with the velocity v, the charged particles are attracted towards the positive terminal of the battery. That means when a charged particle enter into the electrical field, it will experience an electric force. The electric force always accelerate the charge. Don't forget, electric force always accelerate the charge. That means it will experience a force. That force, we know that F is equal to EQ. This force we can call it as electric force. And according to the Newton's second law, F is equal to ma. If both are equal, so ma is equal to eq, so a is equal to eq by m. Where q is the charge, q can be taken as minus e if it is an electron. So a is equal to eq by m. That means we know that electric force will accelerate the charge. Okay, electric force will be accelerate the charge. Now, let us assume that if I am going to say, this is for the electric force. If I am going to send an electron through the magnetic field, so it will experience a force again. In the electric field, it will experience an electric force. If it is entered into the magnetic field, let me take, this is the magnetic field. The magnetic field is denoted by the letter or not into. The into indicates that the magnetic field is acting perpendicular to the plane of the board. Okay, it's acting perpendicular. For example, if you are sending a charge Q, a charge either it can move in the clockwise direction or it can move in the anti-clockwise direction. But here it will make a circular force. That means The magnetic field, you see the electric force. The magnetic force just change the direction. It never accelerates, okay? Just change the direction. So it never accelerates. Then what is the work done? The work done by the magnetic force always equal to zero because the acceleration is equal to zero. So it never do a work. Which one? The magnetic force. The magnetic force cannot accelerate the charge. But it can just what not change the direction of the charge particle. Okay, that means it will make, it depends on the nature of the charge. If it is a positive charge, it may make what not a anti-clockwise direction. If it is a negative charge, it can be what not a make in the clockwise direction. The direction of the charge particle can be found out by using Fleming's left hand rule. That also we have learned in 10th standard. According to the Fleming's left hand rule, you can able to find out the nature of the circle, whether it is a clockwise or in the anti-clockwise. For example, I am sending here with the velocity v. According to the Fleming's left hand rule, you have to stretch the thumb, forefinger and the central finger mutually perpendicular to each other. Okay, they are mutually perpendicular to each other. Here, just to keep it FBI. CBI, you know, correct? Not similarly, you keep it as FBI. F force, B for magnetic field, and I for current. FBI. So, here we need to find out the force. So, let us assume that I is the direction of the current, and that means if the central finger indicates the direction of the current and the forefinger indicates the direction of the field, then the thumb indicates the direction of the force experienced by the magnetic field. For example, let us assume that the charge is a positive charge if it is plus Q. Okay? If it is plus Q means in which direction it is moving, that is the direction of the current. Okay? So the direction of the current denoted here. Okay? And the magnetic field is into, so it will be acting into. So the force will be acting in which direction? Upper direction. So it will experience the force in the upper direction if it is a positive charge. Okay, so it deviates from the path and reaches here. Understood now? Suppose if it is a negative charge, instead of taking positive, if I consider this as a negative, now what will happen? If the negative charge means the charge is accelerated, velocity will be along what not, which is a positive x-axis. So if the electrons are moving in the positive x-axis, you know that the direction of the current will be just opposite to the electron. So the current direction will be towards which direction here? Okay, so this is the direction of the current now. So this is the direction of the field. See now, this is the direction of the current and this is the direction of the field. Okay. Sorry, left hand. Left hand. So this is the direction of the current. Then field should be there in towards what are the paper. So this will be the direction of the force. The force will be towards which direction? Downward direction. So the force is downward direction means it will experience a force, answer, it will move in the form of clockwise direction. So negative charges into the field means it is moving in the form of clockwise. Understood, Nada? Day, you have to be careful, but use the left hand, not the right hand. If you use the right hand, again the direction will be changed. So you have to use the left hand. Force means left hand, okay? So if you want to find out the force, you have to use Fleming's left hand and we can able to find out the direction. Now, the magnetic force is given by the formula Fm. Fm is equal to V into, Q into Vd. Vd means drift velocity of the electron into the magnetic field. Okay, Fm, it's a vector quantity. Fm is equal to Q into Vd vector cross B vector. Okay, so if you want to write this thing, that is will be equal to Vq Vd into sin theta into n cap. The n cap is a unit vector, it gives the direction, and this will be the magnitude, and we can able to find out the value, numerical value, by using one of Vq Vd sin theta. So here Vd is not compulsory. The D indicates only the drift velocity, otherwise you can write one under BQV sin theta. So my Fm is equal to Q into V vector cross B vector. Here the Fm always perpendicular to the velocity and the Fm vector always perpendicular to the magnetic field, because you know that A vector is equal to B vector cross C vector. That means A vector perpendicular to B vector and A vector perpendicular to C vector. That means if the BB lies in the plane XY, assume that B and V lies in the plane XY, then the force will be acting either in the upward direction or in the downward direction. Understood? That means the force always perpendicular to the plane which contains what not a velocity and a magnetic field. Here the V and B may or may not perpendicular, that we don't know that, but this force we can call it as magnetic force. The magnetic force is given by the formula Fm is equal to Q into V cross B, or you can write as BQV sin theta, or we can write as another BQV sin theta. So this is the formula. So there are three cases again. Case one, if theta is zero, theta is zero means what, na? They are moving parallel. Here theta is the angle. See, all the cases in the formula, if the angle present means we must know that the angle between two physical quantity. Okay, that physical quantity we must know. So here theta is the angle between the velocity and the magnetic field. So if case one, let us assume if theta is zero, that means V parallel to the magnetic field. What will happen? Sin 0, 0, then force Fm will be 0. Okay, in the case 1, if theta is 0. Second case, let us assume if theta is equal to 190, again sin 190, it's what, not a anti-parallel, V will be anti-parallel to V, again force will be 0. Then third case, if theta 90 degree, then what will happen? Then Fm is equal to BQV sin 90 is the maximum. So this is the maximum value of the force. If it is 270, again it will experience a force. Theta is equal to 270 degree, then it will experience a force minus BQV. That means these two are perpendicular. These two are opposite, sorry, not perpendicular. They are not anti-parallel. If it is acting clockwise, this will experience in order anti-clockwise. Okay, so these are about the magnetic force. This force only we can call it as the magnetic force. There is a special name. That name only we can call it as Lorentz force. L-O-R-E-N-T-Z. Okay, so this we can call it as another Lorentz force. Fm is equal to Q into V cross V. What is it, not a? That force we can call it as another Lorentz force. Okay, suppose if a charge particle, now let me ask one more question, okay? Da? So first we have sent the charge particle only through the electric field. What does the electric field do? The electric field will accelerate the charge. The magnetic field will change the direction, but the work done by the magnetic field always equal to 0 because it never accelerates the charge. But the electric field can do the work, but magnetic field cannot do any work. Now, let us take a crossed field. Cross field means what, nada? Two field perpendicular to each other. Let me take, this is a plate. This has positive nature, this has negative nature. And let me take here, this is the north and this is the south. So the magnetic field B will be acting towards this direction. Electric field E will be acting towards this direction. The both are acting perpendicular to each other. This type of field only we can call it as a cross field. It's look like a cross. So this field we can call it as a cross field. So now let me send a charge particle through the cross field. This is the electron. We are going to send the electron towards this. That means the electron is moves perpendicular to the electric field and magnetic field. Now what will happen? It will experience two forces. One is electric force and another one is another magnetic force. The electric force will accelerate the electron. The magnetic force will change the direction of the electron. So here it will experience both the force. So the net force F is equal to Fm plus Fe. Fm indicates the magnetic force, that we know that Q into V vector cross what not a V vector plus this, you know that E vector into Q. So here Q is constant, so you can write a E vector plus V vector cross V vector. This is the net force experienced by an electron or a charged particle when it is enter from a crossed when it is entered into the cross electric field. Okay, so here the Q will be equal to plus or minus N, where N is the number of free electron, plus indicates that it's a proton, minus indicates that it's an electron. So this is the formula for the force experienced by the combination of electric and magnetic field. If both are together, then it will experience a force. Okay, so now let us move on to the next thing. The force experienced by the current carrying conductor placed in a uniform magnetic field. Let us assume that we are going to keep a conductor in a magnetic field. See, here we have learned before, still we have learned that the force experienced by a charged particle, only an electron or a proton. Now I am going to keep a conductor. We are going to keep not a conductor inside the electric field. What will happen? If a conductor is placed inside the electric field, what will going to be happen over here? So for example, let me take, this is the direction of the magnetic field. Okay. And this is the conductor. We are going to place a conductor over here. Assume that this is the conductor. Okay. The length of the conductor, let me take it as L. And the area of cross section of the conductor, let me take it as A. Or let us take here. This is the area of cross section. Here the current entering towards what under this direction. Then the electron will be drifted in the just opposite direction, because electron and current are always in the opposite direction. That means the current always moving in the opposite direction of the motion of electron. So Vd is the velocity of drift velocity of electron, and I is the current. Okay, so let us assume that which makes an angle theta with the magnetic field. So theta is the angle between the magnetic field and the length of the conductor. And let us assume that N is the number of electron per unit volume. Okay. Then capital N is the total number of electron. That you know, the total number of electron is equal to N into volume. So volume is nothing but area into length. So capital N can be written as NAL. So small capital N is equal to N into A. Now it will experience a force. So it will experience a magnetic force, and the magnetic force, we know the formula, Fm is equal to Q into Vd cross V. Okay, Fm is equal to Q into Vd cross V, where Q is the charge of the electron. Okay, so before that, let us go for the current. Let me take that, you can write as, then Q is equal to minus Ne, where N is the total number of electrons, that time it is sorted as minus Ne into Vd vector cross V vector, and you know the value of N. So from here you substitute the value of N. So what will get? NALE into Vd vector cross V vector. So that is equal to minus NALE Vd cross V vector. Because these all are constants, so I can write this way, minus Na LEVD cross or not a V vector. Sure. Consider this as equation 1. Now let me find out the net current I. I is equal to Q by T. The Q can be written as N E by T. N you can write as N E L E divided by T. See here, this is the distance, this is the time. Okay, so the distance by time is equal to velocity. So what will get? NaVd. So here, let us assume that the charge of the electron is negative. Or okay, let us assume that NaVde. So I is equal to NaVde. Already we have derived this relation in the current electricity also. Now, both the side, let me multiply with the L. If I multiply with the L, that will become current element. Current into length means that we can call this a current element. So I into L is nothing but current element. current element is a vector. See da, it's very important. Current is a scalar, but current element is a vector. So IL vector can be written as a minus into NaVd. See here, here on minus. This minus indicates the drift velocity and current are in the opposite direction. Let me take this as equation 2. So here what is there? Minus NaLeVd. Here what is there? Minus NaLeVd. So instead of writing that, I can substitute on IL. So substitute 2 in 1. Then what will get? Fm is equal to IL vector cross what not B vector. So this is the formula for the force experienced by the current carrying conductor. See that? Fm vector is equal to IL vector cross what not B vector. That means if you are writing in terms of magnitude, what will get nada? So let me write here. That means Fm vector is equal to BIL cross product, so sin theta and n cap. You will be getting on that BIL sin theta and n cap, where theta is the angle between the magnetic field and the length, I is the current. Okay, then for maximum, let us take theta 0 or what not 190 degree. Again, it never experiences a force, the Fm will be equal to 0. Okay, now second case. Theta, let me take it as out of 90 degree. If 90 degree means Fm will be maximum, that is equal to BIL. Okay, the main difference between Fm is equal to BIL and another one, Fm is equal to BQB. The main difference here, charge particle, but here a conductor of length L. That is the main difference. Here the charge moving with the velocity V. Here the conductor carrying a current I, but both will experience a force, but both the force are different. Here Fm is equal to BQV sin theta, but here Fm is equal to BIL sin theta. Simply you can say it as what not a Bill sin theta. Again the direction of the force can be found by Fleming's left hand rule. Okay, the Fleming's left hand rule is used to find out the direction of the force experienced by the current carrying conductor placed inside the uniform magnetic field. Okay, students. So let us stop it here and thank you. Okay.